in rack and pack refrigeration systems, how do they control the temperature in each room considering different temperature requirements? And the simple answer, basically, if you had a system evaporating, let's say the majority of your rooms were at minus 20, but you had one room that, I don't know, let's say you wanted minus 10, then you would basically fit an evaporator pressure regulator on the evaporator to throttle the suction being pulled back to the pack. Again, let's go to our famous whiteboard here. I'll try and use a different color, see if that makes it a little clearer. I'll draw as big as possible. Sorry for the view of the back of my head. So if we have our pack, here we can see that. Is that reading back to front or the right way around? Yeah, back to front, never mind. So let's say we've got three evaporators and we've got minus 20, minus 20, and let's say minus 10. So we've got our common suction going back to our pack. Obviously we've got our common liquid with our TXV feeding the evaporators. Oh, that one's gone a bit too far, look. So we've got the liquid in and we've got our suction back to the pack. Now the pack's working at minus 20 evaporating temperature. So that one's going to evaporate minus 20. That one's going to evaporate at minus 20. If we want that one at minus 10, basically what we do is we put an evaporator pressure regulator valve on the suction line. And basically what that does is it controls that temperature or that pressure temperature relationship. So we basically throttle that suction gas coming back to the pack. So instead of, let's say, pulling an awful lot back, we let this pressure build a little bit in the evaporator until we've got the right pressure for minus 10. So yeah, relatively simple. And obviously you can do that on, you know, if you've got minus 10, I don't know, let's say minus 5, you could do the same thing. Let's do it the proper way. So your pack will always evaporate at your lowest evaporating temperature that you need on site.